I love math class. I like to welcome Dr. Chandrasekharan sir, who is right now dean of Vijay Group of Schools, and also he is having a very good experience as a principal for past 25 years. So I thank you so much, sir, for being here to talk to our students. So starting our session, still students are joining, but sharp 6 o'clock we are joining this session. Yeah, you can start your session. After Dr. Chandrasekhar, Saugati ma'am will start the classes. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. A very good evening to one and all gathered here. I am Dr. Chandrasekhar, dean of a group of schools in Krishnagiri and Hosur. Today I am very happy to meet you all through this online program. I know both our group for more than 10 years, because 10 years before itself they have started IIT coaching. Online IIT coaching they have started, and they were the first person who brought the American astronauts to interact with the Indian school students. So in that way, I know very well the Gopal Guru. I appreciate their sincerity, dedication, and commitment. And today, I just want to meet all these students before starting up this program. See, my aim is just you should be motivated. Motivation cannot be given by outside force. You yourself should get it, and you have to get motivated by yourself. See, before that, I just want to tell you one thing. Math is a very, very important subject. That is why math is known as the queen of science. Without math, you cannot have any sort of journey of learning in your life. So math is very, very important. I just want to tell you one thing in connection with it. I think you all might have heard about surgeon Sasruta of ancient medicine, the very first surgeon, I think. He mentioned, whenever a patient comes, he used to tell, if you know simple mathematics, definitely I can take out the disease from you. The simple mathematics is, if you know whether one is bigger than two or two is bigger than one. If you know two is bigger than one, it's very simple. I can easily take you out of the disease. I can free you. See, here we are three people, who Sasruta used to say. Here we are three people. One, you. Second, myself. Third, the disease. If you join me, we two can together send the disease easily out. Because those days, Sasruta had to do surgery without anesthesia or any sort of painkillers. So the expectation of cooperation from the patient is very, very essential. So for that also, this simple mathematics is very, very important. So I want to say, in such a way, math is a very, very important subject, and I am happy that you are starting this program with mathematics. Before going to that, I just want to tell you a simple example. This is an egg. Egg can be broken either by the external forces or by the internal forces. Both the chances are there. You can break it from outside like this. If you break it from outside, even a parotta master knows that. But if you break it from outside, you can make only an omelet. Even only if it is broken from inside forces, internal forces, then only the beautiful life will come out. So that is why, if you are doing anything just because of the compulsion of somebody else, definitely you will become an omelet. Even for studies also, if you yourself as the internal thirst to do it, then only you can come out with flying colors in that particular field. So what I am saying is develop that sort of internal. Internal is very, very important. Take a pencil. From pencil, you can learn so many things. Correction is possible. So whenever you do any sort of mistake, you can correct it. Similarly, impression. Wherever you go, you can do the impression there. You should do it. You see, you write with a pencil or a paper. Afterwards, you just erase it. Even after erasing everything, you can find the impression. On the external sides of the pencil, finally, that will be scrapped and that will be thrown out into the dustbin. But which is important is the inner one. So the important thing is get inside. So the inner change is very, very important. So that's why you yourself should come out with the idea that, yes, I should learn. Not because of my dad's compulsion, not because of my mom's compulsion, not because of the torture of my grandfather. I should learn. I should study. If you break it in such a way, that is breaking from inside, then definitely the beautiful life will come out. And mathematics is a very, very important part in your life. So what I am saying is, two things to break an egg from inside, just two things is enough. One, among all the organs presented by the God to you, to us, which is important means, yes, that alone is important. So that is why even in Tamil also, the word kel is very, very important. That can be explained by four or five English words like hearing, listening, questioning, following, and so many other words are there to explain that single word Tamil, kel. So what I am saying is that listening is very, very important. See, God has given you eyes, but He gave us four lids to close. God has given us mouth. And He gave two lips to close. But what about the ears? No closure is there. That means what He wants to say. He wants to say, use your eyes and mouth whenever it is necessary, but use your ears always. So what I am saying is, listening is very, very important. That is why the great scholar, Tamil scholar, Thiruvalluvar also says, Selvathul Chellum, Sevichellum. So, heart, even the heart, which is the heart of the heart, you write the word heart, H-E-A-R-T. Heart of the heart is your ear. The central part of the heart is ear, E-A-R. Even if you cut both the earlobes and you keep it together, you can find the heart. I think now you can come to know about the importance of the ear. So, just to listen. That listening is very, very important. That is the first part of your planning. Abraham Lincoln says, if I am asked to cut a tree in 7 hours, I will spend 6 hours in sharpening my axe. So what I am saying is, all these classes going to be conducted by Gopher Guru from now onwards. That is going to sharpen your axe. So please open your ears. Whenever the teacher enters into the class, your eyes, your ears, your brain, and every aspect should be concentrated towards the teacher in the blackboard. If you do like that, definitely you can win. No doubt at all. So with that, I'm blessing you all people to come up in your life just by listening to these classes. And I want to tell you one more thing also. Whatever you learn, that you have to work it out. And early morning is a very, very important time for that. Because I'm not saying by any other way. scientifically I am saying, only in the early morning ozone layer is kept open. So if you get up early in the morning and you can just rush up all those things what was taught the previous evening by your teachers, then definitely nobody can win. You cannot be second to none. So what I am saying is, please concentrate and continue these classes. Listen to your teachers. Go for Guru has appointed all excellent teachers, well experienced teachers. You listen to them and come up in your life. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Okay, sir. Okay, welcome, welcome.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Good evening, Sahitya ma'am. You can start now.
So, hi students. How are you? I think all are doing great. So, you know the topic of the today's session is quadratic, right? So, before going into the session, I wanted you to ask why they kept the name as quadratic. Why? So, at the age of like fourth grade or fifth grade, you used to learn the quadrilaterals. So, quadrilaterals had four sides, right? So, they have kept it as quadrilaterals. But why this name is a quadratic? It doesn't have any grade or degree of four, right? So if any student know why it is a quadratic, then you can please post the answer on chat. I can give you a minute. Anyone know why is it a quadratic? You can message me in chat. Okay. Anyone? Okay, no problem. Let's learn today. Okay, learning is good, right? So let's learn why is it. Okay, Shankar sir, can you please give me the sharing option? I need to share my screen.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, I have it. So let's see the PPT now. I hope all can see my PPT, right? So quadratic. So it is obtained from the Latin word quadratus. It's obtained from the Latin word quadratus, which means the square, right? Yes. So equation, what is the equation? Means you are equating something to the other one, right? Here I have written the basic quadratic equation as x squared plus ex plus c equal to 0, right? Can you see this equal symbol? Means you are equating this to 0, right? Yes, very good. So can you tell me what is the degree of the quadratic? What is the degree of the quadratic?
Two.
Very good. So degree of the quadratic is 2. So quadratic is obtained from the Latin word quadratus, which is nothing but the square, right? So as it has a square function, it is called as a quadratic. Got it? Very good. Now let's see. It is a second order equation. It is a second degree. Got it? So here, if you can see, you can ask me what is this ABC. ABCs are nothing but the numbers, which are also, A is also called as the coefficient of x squared, B is called the coefficient of x, and C is the constant. Got it? So if I ask you one question, suppose, can I take A as 0? Will that be still a quadratic? If I take
no.
A as 0, no, very good. That's right. It's a no. Why? Because if A is 0, then we'll have only the bx plus c. It's not a quadratic. we thought that the quadratic is nothing but it should be a square, but this is a linear. So the equation ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, in that definitely a should not be equal to 0. We can have b as 0 and c as 0, it will be still a quadratic. Okay, yes, yes. Let's move on to the next one. The basic quadratic equation is nothing but x squared. How are you getting the x squared? Anyone? How will we get the x squared from ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0? How are we getting the x squared? Yes, we are getting the x squared from this one by taking the b 0, c 0, a equal to 1. Okay, plug in these values into the quadratic. Got it? So you'll get the x squared. This is called the basic function or the parent function. Got it? Okay, let's move on to the next one. So here I'm talking from that time, equation means we need to know how to solve this equation, right? So how many ways can anyone tell the ways to solve this quadratic equation?
Four ways.
Very good. Four ways. Perfect. That's right. So let's see what are those. So the four ways of solving quadratic equations are factorization, right? Completing the square, quadratic formula, and by using graphs, right? Okay, one more question. So how many roots will have the quadratic equation have? Like how many solutions?
Two.
Very good. So max two. Why can't we have three? Why can't we have three?
Then it is quadratic.
Yes, very good. So the highest degree of the quadratic is 2. So we can have only 2 solutions, right? Very good. So now let's see in step by step how to solve these things using first factorization. Okay. In factorization, we have 3 methods. One is when B is 0, C is 0, when all are there, means A, B, C is there. Okay. When B is 0, let us see the steps when B is 0, how to solve it. Okay. Yes. Suppose the equation was like ax squared plus bx plus c equal to 0. So if I plug in b as 0, what is the equation we have now? Anyone? If you plug in b as 0.
0b plus c is equal to 0.
Very good. So it turns out to be ax squared plus c equal to 0. Wow, I have had so many number of active students in my class. That's great. Now let's see a small example for this. Okay. So suppose if I take the quadratic equation like this, how to solve it? So what will be your first step? What will be your first step? Shall I send the constant to the other side of the equation? So negative 32 goes to the other side, becomes positive, right? We have learned in equations like positive goes that side, becomes negative. Negative goes the other side of the equation symbol, becomes positive, right? Same way, multiplication goes that side, becomes
division.
Anyone? Very good. Yes. So this 2 is multiplied to the x squared, goes that side, becomes division, right? So x squared is 16. Now what should I do? What should be my next step here? I have a square. How should I get rid of the square? Shall I take square root? Very good. So here I think I have made one mistake here. Can you guess what is that mistake? Can anyone correct me? I made a mistake at this step. What is that? While taking the square root, we should plug in pos. Wow, that's correct. Yes, plus or minus. So why should I keep this plus or minus means? I told x squared is 16, right? So positive 4 squared is also 16. Negative 4 squared is also 16, right? So that's why we should keep a positive or negative sign. So the solution of this will become positive 4 or negative 4. Got it? Let's move on to the next one. So before that, let's go. So when b equal to 0, we have few steps over here. What is that? You'll keep the ax squared towards the left side and move the constant towards the right side. Okay? And after doing that, you will divide that a to the other side, right? Because a is in the multiplication, you move on to the next side, so it becomes division. Yes? Once the division is done, what will you do? You'll take the square root, keep the positive or negative. It's very simple, right? Yes? So actually, I think maths, it will be difficult for everyone because you need to mug up so lots and lots of formulas. So let's learn it in the science way. Like, there will be some procedure for everything in science. So in maths also, there will be, the scientists didn't discover all the formulas just like that. There is some reason behind each and every formula. And if you know that reason, it will be very easy. Okay, you can play with the maths. So the next one is when c equal to 0. Now let's see how to solve this equation when c equal to 0. So let's write that now. So if c is 0, what happens to the equation? Anyone?
Ax squared plus bx is equal to 0.
Very good. That's right. Yes. Now let's have one example of this. 3x squared minus 6x equal to 0. Okay. Yes. So can anyone tell me here what is the HCF of these two numbers, highest common factor of these two numbers? Highest common factor?
3.
Yes. 3x, right? 3x. So take that as a common. If you're taking that as a common, what is remaining? So for that, just divide this with 3x. So I think in the first one only x will be there. In the second one, 2 will be there, right? Yes, got it so far? So just we are taking the HCF of those two things which we have and you're taking it out. If you have a doubt that what will be inside the brackets, you can divide them and do it, okay? So now if you can see here, we have here two. This is first and this is the second. This is called zero product rule. Zero product rule, which means if something like A times B is 0, then A equal to 0 or B equal to 0. So here we need to equate each one of them to the 0, okay? So 3x is 0 or x minus 2 is 0. Can anyone solve for me and give me the answer?
X is equal to 0 or x is equal to minus 2.
Minus 2 goes that side because?
Plus 2.
Very good. Yes. So the solution of this equation is 0 or 2. Got it right? Yes. Now let's see the steps here. Same thing. Everything will be on one side. The other side should be 0. You're taking the HCF of those and then zero product principle you're applying and you're equating each factor to the 0 so that you'll have two linear equations. Solving those two linear equations, you'll have the two solutions for them. Right? Now let's move on to the factoring. When ax squared plus bx plus c is there with you. Let's see one example for that, okay? Yep. So before moving to that, let me give you some two things now. Okay, 3x squared minus 27 equal to 0. Solve this, everyone. 5x squared plus 6x equal to 0. You can solve it and give me the answers.
And what is the question?
You can see on board. Can you see? I'm sharing the screen, right? I have written there.
There is no question on the board.
No, ma'am. There is no question.
Can you see the question?
It is on slide 6, ma'am. Steps for solving the quadratic.
Oh, then up to now, you didn't see any one of my working out on paint?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Oh, then you should have informed me. No, okay. Maybe it's not. Yeah. Can you see now? Yes. Is it okay
yes,
now?
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you. Just tell me if you can't see, because I was not just telling you the questions, I was writing here. If you can't see, just let me know, okay? Yes, you can solve these two questions now. These two questions on board.
Ma'am, first two and three.
Mm-hmm. Okay, just three. While taking the square root, we should
plus or minus three.
Plus or minus.
Yes, that's right. Second one, please. Second one.
X is equal to 0 or minus 6 by 5.
Very good. That's right. Perfect. Now let's see if everything is there, how to solve it. Let's take one small example here as well. X squared minus 5x plus 6. Right? Okay. So here this method is called splitting the middle term. Everyone can see my board, right? Yes. Okay. So here we are going to
minus split 3 the minus 2.
Term. How to split the middle term? Wow, that's good. So multiply the coefficient of a and the constant. Middle term coefficient is negative 5. You need to split that in such a way that if you multiply, you get 6. If you add, you get negative 5. So, as the answer, it is negative 3, negative 2. Because negative 3 times negative 2, you get positive 6. Negative 3 plus negative 2, you get a negative 5, right? So, this is how we split the middle term. Yes. So after splitting the middle term, just write it down of the middle term like this. Again, take the HCF. What is the HCF of these two? X, right? So the remaining is X minus 3. From these two, take the negative 2 common. So the remaining would be X minus 3 again. So why did I take the negative 2? Why didn't I take positive 2? Can anyone answer?
Both answer the same.
Minus 3 will be coming common.
Yes.
Ma'am, X can be 2 and 3. Ma'am, X minus 2, X minus 3, ma'am.
Very good. Yes. Now take that X minus 3 common. So we have X minus 2, right? Now once you get this zero product principle, right? Each linear to 0. Yes.
X is equal to 2 or 3.
One student. Yes. Very good. Yes. Any doubts?
No, ma'am.
Ma'am, can you spare
for a
minute?
Yeah, sure. Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Got it? So now I post you one more question. 2x squared plus 3x minus 2 equal to 0. Can anyone try to answer this?
Ma'am.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I'm there.
Shall I answer, ma'am?
Sorry?
Ma'am, shall I answer, ma'am?
Yeah, sure. Come on.
Minus
this
2.
This is the question. Okay. X equal to minus 2.
And X on 1 by 2.
Very good. That's right. Okay. Let's see the steps. Okay. For the other students. So, it was 2x squared plus 3x minus 2 equal to 0. Now write it. What is the product of the A and C? It should be here. It should be AC. It should be B here. So product of AC is negative 4.
4 and minus 1.
Very good. Yes. 4 and minus 1. Right? We can check such that if you're multiplying these two, you're getting negative 4. If you're adding these two, you're getting a 3. Right? So 2x squared plus 4x minus 2. From the first two, shall I take 2x as a HCF? We'll have x plus 2, right? And from last, take the negative 1, so it will be x plus 2, right? Yes? Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
yes ma'am.
Very good. Yes, ma'am. Let's equate each one. Yeah, 2x minus 1 times x plus 2. Right? So now, next step is just equating this linear to 0. Right? Yes? So, negative 1 means it goes to the other side, becomes positive 1. Right? And then what happens? Multiplication of 2 goes that side.
1 by 2.
Very good. That's right. Positive 2 goes that side, becomes negative 2. So we have two solutions here. Got it? Yes? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Very good. So now let's move on to the next one. Okay. So the next one, suppose if it, the equation is like this, 3x squared, or suppose x squared minus 3x minus 2 equal to 0. Can you use factoring method here and tell me the answer? Factoring?
No,
what will be the factors? How will you split it? Someone is drawing it on my board. Please stop that because I can't write it if you are drawing like this. Okay. Sorry. Yeah, thank you. Please stop doing that. Okay. Yeah. So now we can't do that. Why? Because there is no factors such that you can add two things and get that. So these questions can't be done by using the factorization method which we are doing up to now. So for this, we need to see some other methods. So shall we learn completing the square now? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Nice. So we are going to the completing the square now for all the questions which we can't do for the factorization. If we are able to do the factorization, just go for it. If you can't, you can just go for the completing the square. Okay? Yes? So all the doubts will be cleared at the end of the session. I can see few students are raising their hands. I'll give you the time for the doubt clarifications. Okay? Yeah. So completing the square in general will be of the form x minus some h whole square equal to k form. Okay? So we need to turn this equation into this form. So let's see the first step is send the constant to the other side. First step is sending the constant to the other side. So negative 2 goes that side, becomes positive 2, right? Yes. In order to make this as a perfect square, here I need to add something. I'll just give you the formula now, okay? Suppose if it was like this, ax squared plus bx, okay? You're going to add minus b by 2a whole square. So here, yes. Or you can take positive b by 2a if it's really confusing for you, okay? So b is negative 3 here, 2 times a is 1. Okay, just 3 by 2 whole square, which is 9 by 4, right? Yes, so that is what I need to add. Shall I add it on one? Shall I add it like that?
I mean,
will that be right? My voice is breaking. Is it okay now?
Yes, ma'am.
Now it's okay now.
It's okay now? Okay. Yeah. Thank you. So if I add this 9 by 4 to only the one side of the equation, will that be right? If I add only this 9 by 4 to one side, will that be right? Will equation be right? No. Why? Because if you're adding to the equation on the both the sides, right? In order to balance the equation. So if I'm adding 9 by 4, you should add the 9 by 4 on the other side as well. Okay? Yes? So the final thing would be this can be written as x plus b by a whole squared. Okay? Yes? I'm scrolling down. So x plus b is what? Is it right or am I doing wrong? You can correct me.
3 by 2.
Anyone? Is this one which I have told is right? I should keep it 2 here, right? Yes? Right, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Again, someone or adding the cross marks, please stop that. If not, the team will just won't give you any permission. So, okay. Yeah, thank you so much. So, this will be right. Now, b is negative 3 by 2 whole squared, right? On the other side, it's a fraction. How will you add a fraction? Can anyone give me the answer for this? 2 plus 9 by 4?
By taking LCM.
Good. Yes, perfect. So by taking the LCM, that's totally fine. So by taking the LCM, here is 4. So it is 4 to the 8 plus 9.
8 plus 9.
17 over 4, right? Yes, right? Now I think we are good to take the square root on both sides, right? Yes?
But 17 won't go in any square tape, no man.
Yeah, it's no problem. Why to worry? You can just take it as a square root of 17. That's it, right? Yes. See here, I'll distribute that square root to both of them. Can I do this step? Can I do this one?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So we can do like this. No problem. So x minus 3 over 2 equal to positive or negative square root of 17 over 2. Okay. So, it is subtraction of 3 by 2. It goes that side, becomes positive. So, if you can see here in this fraction, there is a common denominator. So, I can add the numerators. Right? Yes. So, if I take the positive, then it is 3 plus square root of 7. If I take a negative, it is 3 minus square root of 17 over 2. Is that clear, this one?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, okay. Shall we move on? So, understood the completing the square, right? Yes? Okay. Now, I'll post you one question for you. Just tell me if you can see that or not, okay? Yes? One small question. 3x squared plus question. Use the plating to solve this. Yeah, everyone can try this now and give me the answer. If I'm teaching you like too fast, you please let me know. I can slow down. Okay. Done?
Ma'am, the answer is 5 minus root 13 by 6 and 5 plus root 13 by 6.
Very good. So you mean like this, right?
Yeah.
Yes, very good. That's right. Perfect. Okay. So what is the other method after this?
Quadratic formula.
Very good. So can you tell me how that formula came?
Yes, ma'am. Like the derivation of the third one.
Yes.
AX squared plus BX plus C equal to 0. Like if you take A out in that, you will get A common in that, you will get A into A times X squared plus B by AX plus C by A equal to 0.
Okay. Then, they have obtained the quadratic formula from completing the square, right? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
So don't need to by heart that, right? So suppose if you are applying the same thing here, your positive C goes that side, becomes negative C, right? Yes. And as you told, if I divide by A, right? Yes. I can distribute for both of them, right? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
So what happens? X squared plus B by A X equal to negative C by A, right? Yes. So yes, after this, what should we do? We should apply the completing the square. So how will you do that? The same thing by adding the B by 2E whole squared on both sides. B by 2E whole squared is nothing but B squared over 4A squared, right? So let's add that on both sides. So X squared plus B by AX plus B squared over 4A squared on both sides. Right? So now what will this side be?
X plus B by 2A the whole squared.
Yes, X plus B by 2A whole squared. So here also the LCM. The LCM is nothing but 4A squared, right? Yes, yes. Did you see my mistake, anyone? No one? I'll be making mistakes during my classes in order to see whether the students are concentrated or not. How did my C became here C squared? Oops. Right? Yes? Okay. Yeah, let's continue. Negative 4ac plus b squared. Is that clear so far? Yes. So what is my next step? I should take the square root, right? What should I do? I should take the square root on both sides. Okay. So I'm just keeping the positive term at first and then I'll keep the negative term, okay? Yes, should I keep a positive or negative here? Yes, I should keep that, right? Now, let's just split the square root for both the numerator and also the denominator. Okay. Yes, got it so far? Because mugging up the formulas is no any use actually. It's not at all useful. So just see how the formula is derived. Okay. Yes. So now we have x plus b over 2a is positive or negative square root of b squared minus 4ac, right? Over that square root of 4a squared becomes 2a, right? Now positive b by side becomes negative b by a. As it is having a common denominator, we can write it like this. What is this now finally? What is this? The final answer which we got.
Quadratic formula.
Very good. Yes. So, we get the quadratic formula from the completing squares. Okay. Yes. Okay. I think you got it. Shall I erase my thing? Shall I erase the board? Yes, everyone can finish with the note down.
Okay. Repeat it again.
Yes. Sorry. Sorry. Okay. So now I shall give you one problem for using the quadratic formula. Use this x squared minus 3x plus 2 equal to 0. Yeah. You please use the quadratic formula here. Or else if you want, I can explain this one and I can do the next one. Okay. The quadratic equation with the standard form like this. Okay. A is 1 here, B is negative 3 here, C is 2. You should say then. Okay. Once you have all of them, what are you waiting for? You can just directly plug in, right? Yes. Okay. So, B is negative 3, so negative. To b squared. If your squared becomes positive, so it's
nice. Your voice is breaking.
What happened?
Ma'am, your voice is breaking.
Oh, is it okay now?
No, ma'am.
The answer is 1 or 2, ma'am.
Is it okay now? Everyone can hear me now? Is it proper?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yeah. Let's continue. Can you see my screen now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes. Ma'am. Okay. So, 2 times A was 1. So negative of negative, it's positive 3 plus or minus 9 minus 4 choose 8 over 2. So 3 positive or negative square root of 1. So what is square root of 1? Actually, I didn't learn. What is square root of 1?
1.
Yes, it's 1. Right. So now I'll take it as a 2. Very good. It's plus 1 over 2. Yes, that's right. 3 minus 1 over 2, right? So it is 4 over 2 is 2. 2 over 2 is 1. Sorry, Nana. Is that clear now? Mm-hmm. Shall we try one? Yes. I don't know why, but it's the full thing is there. Let me check it again. The Wi-Fi signal is good. I don't know what's happening. Is it okay now? Is it still cracking?
No, ma'am. Now it's like kind of.
Oh, okay. Thank you. Yep. Okay, let's start now. Shall I give you one question on quadratic formula?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Are you ready? Okay.
Yes.
Yes. 5x squared plus 6x plus 1 equals to 0. Try this one.
Can you
try for this one, please? 5x squared plus 6x plus 1. Equal to 0. Can you see my board?
Ma'am, x can be minus 1 or x can be minus 1 by 5, ma'am.
X can be? Oh, I think you have solved it using factoring, right? Or did you use a quadratic formula?
Quadratic formula, ma'am.
Okay, that's right. Perfect. Okay. So, let's move on to what is one more. What's the next method? What's the next method which is remaining in the quadratic formula? Any guess? Graphing, right? Yes? Okay. Everyone can hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So, in graphing method, how will you solve the equation? Anyone know? In graphing? Using graphing method, how will you solve the quadratic equation? Yes. So if I give you some graph, okay, I'll show you the graph now. Tell me how you will get the equation from that, okay? I'm sharing my screen. Please let me know if you can see my screen. Okay. Yes, I'm sharing my screen. Can you see that?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, it's just a rough graph. If I give a quadratic equation like this, so can you tell me what are the solutions for this?
-1 and -2.
Very good. So how come you know that it's a -1 and -2? Yes. So intersecting, right? It's intersecting at the x, right? Yes, x axis. Those are the solutions. So here it is intersecting at 2, here it is intersecting at -1. So these are the solutions, right? Perfect. For suppose if the graph was like this, how many solutions will it have?
One solution.
Very good. That's right. If it's like this,
then
zero solution.
Very good. Yes, yes, yes. We can't tell it as is why, because zero is also is one of the root, right? If I draw like this, it's a zero. We can't tell it's a zero. You can tell no solution. Don't use zero. Zero is also a number. If I tell zero, means I can take it as an x square, because x square has a zero, right? Root at x equal to zero. So you can tell it as a no solution. So when will the no solution case be there? When will that occur?
When no point intersects x axis.
That's right. Mm-hmm. When will the no point intersect x axis?
When there is no zero for the equation.
Imaginary roots, right? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Right? Okay. So we have a discriminant. Do you know that discriminant?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So what is that? Why will we use
it? B² - 4AC.
Very good. Why will we use this?
We use it to determine whether it has a real roots or an imaginary root.
Right. Very good. So when this determinant is greater than zero, we'll have two real solutions. Right? Yes. When this discriminant is equal to zero, we will be having one real solution. Yes. When this discriminant is less than zero, we'll be having no solution.
Imaginary.
Right. This is where the complex numbers came from. Okay. See, the math is attached from one thing to the other, right? So complex numbers or the imaginary will come from here. Got it? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
So for this case, the graph looks like this. It will not touch anything and it will be like this. Any doubts in this topic, the discriminant?
No, ma'am.
No. Okay, perfect. So suppose if it was like this, 3x squared plus 6x plus 9 equal to 0, how will I graph this? My teacher gave me this question and she's asking you to graph this. How will you graph a quadratic equation? Yes, you can just tell me how will you graph it, just the steps. Mm-hmm. Anyone, what are the steps to graph a quadratic equations? Yes, shall I use a table method? Yes. So can you tell me when x is 0, what is this? If x is 0?
9,
ma'am.
Very good. If x is 1?
Ma'am.
If x is 1?
18.
Right. Very good. That's right. So
no real
we'll solution, be graphing ma'am. For this. Wow. No real. Why? B² - 4AC, right? So you got less than zero. Yes,
it is less than zero.
Yes, perfect. So how will with this graph look like?
Get any value.
Yes, perfect. So no real solutions. Why? Because here the discriminant is less than zero. So without having look itself, we can estimate the shape of the graph and how it looks like. Right? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Very good. Okay. So now I welcome the doubts from you. Have you, like we have discussed, now quadratic equation, there are four methods: factoring, completing the square, quadratic formula, and graphing method. So do you have any doubts in that discuss so far?
I have doubt in the quadratic formula.
The quadratic formula. Okay, what's the doubt?
Ma'am, like you said, some from something they derived it. Ma'am, what is that?
Completing the square, we have shown. We have discussed the step by step how they have got, right? Oh, we did the completing the square. Yeah, it's from that itself. Okay. All of you are using the pi as 3.14, right? The circle's area and the circumference, yes, you are using the pi as 3.1. Why is it 3.14? Why can't it be some 6 or why can't it be some 2?
2 by 7 is 3.14.
Yes. Why? Yeah, why? Because I know it's 3.14, but why?
We cannot use
1 by 1.
Just for us to make the calculation easier.
Sometimes we need a decimal.
Okay.
Value, mom, for substituting. Instead of fraction, we are using
3.4. Okay. Yes, if you are taking the fractional values 22 over 7, also no problem. But that, where did it come from? So each and every maths fact will have some procedure. The scientists just then discovered that, let us keep the pi value as a 22 by 7. Let us keep it as a 3.14. It's not like that. Everything has a reason behind that. So why is this pi means? The scientists took all the circular things, means which is in round shape. He measured the circumference and he had noticed that all the circumference was having the common ratio as circumference divided by the diameter. I'll show you. Let me explain you in paint. Okay. Yeah. So that pi is equal to circumference divided by the diameter. So every time he got the same answer, like 22 by 7 or 3.4. Every time it was the same thing. So he decided to keep the pi as 3.14.
Yeah.
Got it?
Hello, ma'am. Hello, ma'am. I have a doubt. Yes, I am a parent.
Yes. Please.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
You said that minus 2, when it goes to the other side of the equation, becomes plus 2. Mm-hmm. Can you say why? Why happens?
I can say you. So usually directly we are not sending it to the other side, sir. It's like just like a balance. Suppose if you are having a balancer, here in this hand, I have suppose like, let me show you. I have anything here with me. Okay. Suppose here, can you see, sir? I'm holding two things in my hand.
Yeah.
Don't have anything. Yes. Okay. I'll talk about the positive two now. So this is a two here and this is a two here. In order to balance this, if I'm adding 2 to this side, should I do the same thing on the other side? Yes. Shankar sir, can you please give me the sharing option? I need to explain this concept. Shankar sir, please give me sharing option.
Ma'am, can you hear my voice, ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Before the end of the session, I thought of giving a reminder to all students, ma'am.
Mm-hmm, yes, sir.
The thing is, actually, we have the recorded session of the whole session, and we are going to send this recorded to all the students, ma'am. Suppose if students ask any questions, they can also send a email to onlineclasses@gofagroup.com. They can this one. The main of this session is Sagiti Madam taught a very nice the basic concepts. We are going to forward the recorded video by tomorrow or today night. We will send to all of your parents' email ID. If you have any questions, please feel free to send onlineclasses@gofagroup.com. Then another thing is every Thursday, see on a weekly once, every Thursday 6 to 7, we are planning to go with these classes. The idea of this class is teaching the basic concepts in depth. And also we like to make sure you are all getting very good marks in the academic side. So we like to motivate you, and also we like to make you to love the subject. So please be thorough, ask any questions, so feel free to ask her, and also feel free to send an email also. So tomorrow our executives, they will call your parents and let them know about your feedback and all how these classes are going on. And so we are bringing the only the best faculties to teach the basics. And also this preparation, not only helping understanding concept, this will help you for, this is a IIT or a IIT JEE foundation course, I can say that, okay? So listen these things very carefully. We are bringing the best faculties. And also to me, there is no average student or below average or above average student. We are all equal. Only thing is we have to do more exercises. After this, we are also going to post lot of exercises in online. So you can solve it also. So we are going to give lot of options. And also see, these classes are chargeable from next week onwards, every Thursday, but it is only monthly $500, like, you know, monthly 500, not dollars, I'm sorry, 500 rupees. It is monthly 500 rupees. So tomorrow our executives will call you and let them know your interest. And every Thursday, 6 to 7, you can meet the staff and you can ask the doubts, and we will go concept by concept. And we will prepare you both the concept side, and also we make sure you are very successful in the academic side. So that's the motive of this one. So once again, sorry for interrupt the class, ma'am. You can continue. Also,
no problem, sir. Thank you.
Next to 5 minutes. Is it okay, ma'am? Now it's 7:03. We'll end the class by 7:10.
That's fine, sir. Yes, sir. Yeah, yeah. In 5 minutes, I can end the class.
All the students. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank
you. Yes, sir. The class was really enthusiastic. I love the students' batch. Thank you. Okay. So for the question asked, I'm going to explain it now. So the sir asked me, why will that negative two go that side becomes positive two? Yes. Right. So I'm having something on here. The balance shows each side five things, right? Each side we have five balls. Right? Yes, it's a subtraction of two here. Yes, we are taking away two. Yes, can you hear me? I mean, everyone are busy in typing, so just asking you, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So, in order to, equation is also the same thing. We can't make this balance up or down. It should be both sides, it should be equal. Suppose if you are taking two from this side, I should do the same thing on the other side. Okay? Yes? If I'm adding two here, I should do the same thing on the other side. So suppose consider our same equation, x minus 2 equal to 0. Yes? If you can't understand like why I'm taking positive 2, just add 2 on both sides like this. Doing same thing on both sides. The equation, it should not be whatever you do, it should be done to the right side. Yes? So it becomes x equal to 2. Without this step, we have directly gone from here to here. So this is the step involved there. You're adding something on both the sides in order to not to disturb the balance. Okay? Here was x minus 2. Here was a 0. Here you're adding 2. And here also you're adding 2. Hope you cleared your doubts. Is it clear, sir?
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. So, see you soon. Bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Can you please repeat it again, the derivation of...
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, students. Thank you for joining.